Okay, everybody, welcome back. OCD Hi-Fi Guy here, and what do we have other than a mess on my floor? We have these. I love these things, man, and I'm stoked to be showing this to you guys. We're going to do the unboxing. These are AGD Production Audion monoblocks. This is how they come to you. Come to you air freight, or, well, you know, whatever, FedEx air, in a nice Pelican case. And then we've got the zip ties, so I can cut these off. Okay, and then one here, two massive ones. Well, let's get in there, see. Yeah, so these puppies, I'm going to, I swear to God, I need one of these things that I can put on. Maybe I have to invent the thing. I need a little hat. I need a cam hat. Okay, so here you can see the emblem. Okay, got that, and this one here, and let me go back a little bit. Okay, and this one here. Okay, let's see. Okay, these are all nice die cut foam, man, it's sweet. Wow, check this out. Okay, dude, let me first tell you, this is like either 6,800 or 75 for these, a pair of these, which, look, there's no company that goes through this nice of a packaging for that low of a retail. This is like the high, this is 20,000 plus type packaging for a $7,500 pair of monoblocks. This is really, really nice. Okay, so we've got our manual here in this nice, little bag with, what else does he have in there? I know that he's got the, it's the manual and stuff. Okay, I'm not going to go pull that out. Remember, I have to do this all one-handed. Okay, so we set that aside. We've got the gloves, which are very nice because these are polished. Yeah, they're the polished ones. You leave fingerprints in these puppies. But I've only got one hand, and so I can't do the Michael Jackson thing right now. I can, however. Well, let's see. I need two hands for this. Okay, so let me set this here, see if that works. Okay, so for anybody getting this, you gotta pull your hands down under the feet. Ugh. Sorry, I didn't mean to give you a shot of my boobies. Okay, shirt is back on. You do not have to see my man boobs. Thank God. Okay, so check it out. Also, these come with killer audiophile grade power cords. I'm going to leave those in here because I've already got some out there. But man, you know, I mean, I've never seen quite an awesome made in America. This is all made in America. Something like this at $7,500. You know, the last thing that I bought at $7,500 showed up in a damn cardboard box, you know, and it was less than I don't know the word I'm looking for. Less than whatever. So I'm going to put these in real quick, put them in the rig, and we will put them, I'm going to put them right here on top of those monos. So we'll have them right, we can put them on top of the transformers. They're small enough to fit right there. And let's hear how they power these 86 dB 4 ohm speakers that we've got, like the blonde ones. Okay, so hang on, I'll be right back. Okay, so behold the AGD Audion. These are like the coolest things. I love these things, and they're so cool. You know why? Because they're little. I mean, they fit in my hand. They're little. These guys are little guys. And they're beautiful. I mean, the aesthetic is just gorgeous. It's got a tube, a GaN tube, a gallium nitride tube that glows orange. So I still get that beautiful tube glow that I have come accustomed to and that I really like. And this is the most cutting edge, technologically advanced amplifier in the market at this time, in my opinion. It is a gallium nitride. This is Class D. And for all of you freaks that haven't embraced Class D, this is what's going to replace everything in hi-fi very shortly. You'll see it happen this year. You'll see after I play this how other manufacturers that haven't gotten with the times should be concerned, because our old amps that we love to make, like they're still 1980s, are pretty much, I mean, this is going to close the coffin on that kind of thing. So anyways, they're little, they're light, they don't get hot. These can deliver 32 amps of current by themselves. Each one can deliver 32 amps of current. That's unheard of. The other specs, if I were to tell you the other specs of these things, you would not believe the specs that come off these new devices. It's just unbelievable. These are patented, by the way. The devices are patented. So inside those vacuum tubes, that's not a vacuum tube, that is a solid state. There's a PC board inside there, inside a KT88 glass envelope. And that allows, well, people like me to still get that tube glow that I love. And then for people at the shows, they drop their Class D bias because they see it's a tube. They walk in, and the next thing you know, they're like, God, this is the best sound I've heard. They can't believe it. Then they start thinking, well, wait, a single KT88 can't make that much power. And then they're toast, because then they just thought that the best sound in the world was from a Class D, which it was. But they had their listening bias down, and they were able to realize it. And I've sold to people like that. And it's funny when they tell me the story, I said, that's exactly what it was intended for. They're like, I couldn't stay. If I knew it was Class D before I came in, I would have never come in. And, you know, and it's funny to hear that. So anyways, we're going to listen to this. And again, we are going straight out of these amps, okay? Straight out of those amplifiers via speaker cable to these speakers here, which are 86 dB and 4 ohm. So they are not easy speakers to drive. So like my single-ended triode stuff, the regular stuff, it can't power those. These can, of course. We listen to those. Those are 120-watt single-ended triode. But now we're going to listen to these Class Ds that people love to make so much fun about. And just listen, and we'll talk. What, by the way, this is for Dale. Pretty exciting, isn't it? Yeah, it is. It's very exciting. If you could hear it here, you'd really be beside yourself wondering, what the heck am I listening to right now? You'd sort of be, your eyes would be creeping. You wouldn't be moving a muscle. Your eyes would be going side to side. You'd be checking it out, looking around. What does he got going on here? Does he have any DSP? How come it sounds so good? How's it doing in this? I don't get it. And I love to watch people's face when they listen for the first time. They all do the same thing, because you can't wrap your head around it. It sounds too good to be true, really. It's like, how is it this good sounding? I don't get it. What's going on in here? Trickery, I tell you, audio trickery. But it's not at all. What it is it's called current technology, and it's called good design. And that's what it is. And you're hearing the latest of the best. That's it right now. And so... We'll play some more songs. I suppose you want to hear every different type of music so we can see what it does in different situations. So let me try and find some very complex orchestral music. Let me try and find some rock music. Let me try and find some dance music. Let me try and find some songs that aren't going to trigger the big red flag with YouTube. And let's give you a little taste of what these little puppies have to offer, because they are phenomenal. So hold on 1 second. I'll be right back. goodbye. Okay, so I don't know if you guys are picking this up, but you've never heard such extended clean highs that are non-aggressive. That is one of the main features of this of these amps. They extend beyond what you're used to. I mean, and it's so clear and so beautiful. You just hear all the air and just detail. It's unbelievable. So now I'm going to play some, that was all the nice, you know, stuff, gentle stuff. Now I'm going to play some more aggressive style. Play some rock. I'll play some dance music. I'll play some maybe a little punk rock if I can find some disco, things like that. We'll throw some stuff at these. And what I'm going to do for this session is I'm going to turn it up a little so we can demand a little more from these amplifiers, because I really want to show you what they're capable of. So hold on. Okay, here we are. Let's have fun. Check that out. Watch the clock tick and fade. Pray for a different state. We can ask but won't receive. But you apologize. The amount of bass these things will drive is crazy. We see through the stars. Burning in the atmosphere. Down on the boat. Listen to the finesse too, so gentle. cool. Yeah, it's pretty clear. Sounds like we're in the bar. On, kids. I have to do like I did last time to get up. Now, let me show you what happens. I'm going to give them too much power. We're normally, a normal amp, you blow something, you break something. Watch how they go out so gracefully. Whoa. Whoa. Holy shit. God. I thought I was gonna make one of them flip. Let's see if they get hot. We'll let them get go into thermal protection. Let's see. I mean, it's fucking loud in here. Look, no distortion at all. I turned these up because to make them go into protection. I wanted to show you guys how gracefully. Bravo, Alberto, man.
Anymore.
God. Whoa. Oh, you've witnessed a miracle. Oh my God, man. Dude, I went over there and turned it up because I wanted to show you how gracefully these things thermal out. Like they don't clip, right? When they get to, they won't clip. They just shut off. You know, one goes quiet. I put it up for sure. I thought we're going to thermal one out. You know, it's going to cut out. No freaking way, man. Did you hear that? They just crushed. They totally stood up and said, uh-uh, and gave me the finger. Oh my God, dude. Most amps will not even play music that evil through them. But I'm, oh my God, like at that volume. I mean, that's a torture test. That song I put on as a pure torture test because it's the music is dark and heavy and it's the best. I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. It's fun. It's fun. That shit is fun for me. That is fun to crank like that. I know half of you don't get it. You don't understand it. I'm still a kid and I love to crank rock and roll. I gotta admit it. Hey, most things do not handle that. They will not handle that. Those little amps completely blew my mind just now, playing at that clip, that volume, with that much bass and that much guitar. I mean, we played through the whole song, and I was waiting for them to go into protection. We're going through the whole song, playing all this stuff, and then in the end, you know, when the reprise comes, and that comes back in all heavy, and I couldn't believe it. All the bass is still there. Nothing's weak. It's just like, and it did not go into, the amps did not go into protection. These things are totally better than I thought, man. I mean, I can't believe that. You guys heard it. I heard, this is the first time I heard it. I never would have turned them up. I turned them up again. I turned them up to that volume with intention of driving them into protection. I thought there's no way. Yeah, I know what I'll do. I know to show these guys how these things will protect. I turned it up and no way. They just went there. Holy crap. They won't embarrass you. Alberto made these things, so they're not going to embarrass you. If you want to show them off, you can show them off. There is no embarrassment here. No shame in the game. Turn it up. We'll do it. Thank you. That was mind-blowing. Okay, so this is what I live for. Experiences like this. This mind-blowing thing, these little amps, that little joy, that whole freak-out session thing that I just had is the best. I live for that. That's totally what makes hi-fi so much fun for all of us, especially the guys that like to crank rock and roll. And I'm sorry to the other guys. I know it's a lot of high screaming and weird and crazy stuff. And it sounds like the devil is in here, you know, lighting things on fire. But for some of us, that's cool. Yeah, we think it's cool. And I do. But that was fun. So bravo, Alberto. Man, what a beautiful man. You've done such a good job on these, dude. You've outdone yourself. You have outdone yourself, man. This is a phenomenal design. This is really, it's beyond what I thought. I mean, I knew they were great. I loved them, but I did not know they could pull that off. I mean, that's insanity. It's like he did something since the last pair I had. He put something in there. Some power. He made them more powerful. I don't think the first production runs were this powerful. And I know what we did. I told you guys, we put in bigger caps. We did a couple things too. And ho, they're not just pretty, kids. They will beat your ass down. Wow. Anybody that thinks Class D isn't the next best thing, you just have no ears and you're just clueless and y'all can just go somewhere else because I just stymied your ass with Class D. 80 watts, no less. 80 or what is it? It was 80, 75. 75 is what they're. 75 watts at 8 ohm. Yeah, that was crazy. And I'll shut up about it now. So it's like, now I want to find out what can we drive into submission? We haven't done that yet. Maybe that should be our next mission. I could find one easy. Right over here, that one, we could drive it into submission. That's 50 watts. We could definitely clip that. It won't clip. It'll just get so much distortion. You'll just be like, ah, turn it off. We could easily, these are 8 watts. We could bury those in an instant. 45 watts over there. Yeah, I don't want to mess with these because these guys, the builds here, they're not trying to do a kick-ass thing. They're trying to do something different. And we will explore the finesse that is 8 watts a different day. But today, You know, we're enjoying the domination that is AGD. That's what we are. Yes. All right. See you.